Hello, FBA Sourcing Simplifiers. This is Steve, and I'm going to show you, in case you missed the live webinar, Refund X-Ray. So you're probably wondering, what is Refund X-Ray? You've heard of OA X-Ray, but this is a totally different program made by the same people. It's called Refund X-Ray. So what this program does is it'll compare reports from Seller Central. And the reports that it would pull will help identify your lost inventory, inventory not returned to the warehouse, returns over 30 days, and damage to your warehouse. Now, in the 10-day free trial, you only get lost inventory. But you should find at least $99, if not more, of lost inventory that will pay for this program for the year. This is $99, and it covers for 1 year, a whole year. And you get a 10-day trial. So hopefully you can earn that $99 in the 10 days, and then you can unlock the other three and make some money. So how does Refund X-Ray work? It's pretty simple. Like I said, you download reports, upload on the Refund X-Ray. Refund X-Ray, in the background with their program, runs through all the data and then spits out an Excel file and a Word document that will show you what's missing, and then you can just easily copy and paste it into Seller Central. Comparing to other services, there was an older company about 1.5-2 years ago. They used to open up about 100 cases for you in one day, and people were getting in trouble with that. And some people now say that a third-party company opening up cases is against terms of service. I'm not sure. But the new one, Amazon, or the older one, Amazon Suites, that wasn't too bad. They give you 20 free credits. They look through your stuff automatically and find stuff. If you get a reimbursement, they minus one credit, and I think it's like $1 or $2 or something for additional credits. This one you can use all year long for $99, run as many reports as you want. And the thing I like about this one is you do everything yourself. You submit the cases yourself, and you can look through your own data. There's not a third-party company looking through all your data in Seller Central. And just to give you, I did the Amazon Suites free trial. I got back about $150 and 20 credits. Refund X-Ray so far, I submitted two reports. One report, I got $120 back. The second report, all the stuff on the report was, they sent me, it said it was lost, but we found these items. So they were saying that the item was lost, and then they found them. So I didn't get any money from the second report, but I have four left from the free trial to do. So I just submit one a day, and then keep it going. And also double check the ones they say that you don't get paid for, because one of them I'm going to dispute because it said that it was lost on the 13th, and it was found on the 7th of December. So the dates aren't adding up, so I might still get refunded for that. So it's basically you come in, you subscribe. This takes you to PayPal. Once you're in PayPal, you sign up. It costs you nothing to sign up. Just make sure if you don't want to keep this after 10 days that you do go back in your 8th or 9th day and remove the charge. They charge you zero, but after the 10th day is when they charge you $99, a recurring payment. But you have to cancel that recurring payment in 9 days. So you're not charged anything. I have 3 or 4 days left on mine. I might actually go in and cancel it and then sign back up next month. Just for reasons, really busy in August. Let me take you to... So after you sign up, this is the Refund X-Ray page after you log in. Oh, and I did leave something off. So you sign up through PayPal, then you would actually go back through, after you sign up in PayPal, to their sign-up page. And this is a part that I forgot when I was doing it. I ended up emailing Tedrick or support, and they sent back saying, oh, you have to go to the sign-up link after the PayPal. So you just put your email that you want to use for your login, Then the PayPal email you use for signing up, and whatever password you want, and then confirm your password. And then that's to sign up, and then you can log in. And then this is the basic dashboard. My trial expires in 3 days. You got lost inventory that you could check. These ones are locked until you go to the full access. So you have not returned to warehouse, returns over 30 days, and damaged in warehouse. But they do let you check for free during the free trial of the lost inventory. So here's the basic screen. You have your inventory adjustment. This is where you upload that file, upload reimbursement file. Name the file name, anything you want. This is, you would upload an Excel file if you want to exclude your past refunds. This is, if you're doing the returns over 30 days, they have 45 days to pay you back, so you don't want to run a report right up till the current day, because Amazon will come back saying it hasn't been 45 days on a lot of stuff. These are what you hit after you upload your adjustment and reimbursement. This spits out a list of all the products in Excel. You'll see this later. This one will give you nice pages of 5 items to copy and paste. Rows per page. So this is if you want to see 5 items at a time on your Word or 10. I recommend leaving it at about 4 or 5, maybe 6 max. And for when you submit your cases. Here is the wording. So right now it just says the following items have been misplaced, lost in Amazon warehouse, and have not been reimbursed. As the allotted time has not passed, would you please issue reimbursement requests for the following items? This is standard on everybody's, so I would suggest you change it into your own words, because Amazon may see that and say, oh, they used the program to find lost inventory. Let's check this one better. It's up to you. I'm going to change mine to saying, I reviewed my account and I think these items were lost. Can you please research and reimburse me? Or let me know where you found them. Something like that. So anyway, the inventory adjustments. If you click on the little link next to it, it takes you to a video. And it actually shows you exactly how to find your reports. You go to Reports, Fulfillment, under Inventory, you'll click Show More, and then you'll go right to Inventory Adjustments. This brings up this page. You want to click on Download. Change your date to exact dates. And for this date, this is where I would put in the date when you first started selling on Amazon, and then the next date's today's date. You click Request Download. And then it will download it. Over here it'll say In Progress, refresh a few times, and then you can download it. And you'll download a simple text file. Then what you do with that file, you hit Browse. Remember where you put that file. It'll say Custom Files down here. You have to change that to All Files, and then you'll find your text. And I named mine First and Second, so I know when to put it in. Your reimbursements, basically the same. You go to Reports, Fulfillment, on the left, under Payments, you'll see Reimbursements, Download, and then you enter in the same dates, Request Download, and then you download that one as well. You would place that one under Reimbursements. You just browse. You do the same thing, you browse to the folder that you put them in. You have to go to All Files, and then that would be the second one. Once you have these, then you click to Excel and to Word, and it'll download the files on your computer. This video is about 3 minutes long, and it shows you exactly how to do that. It talks about 5 to 10 items in the statement. And here is your Word file. It prints them out. He had 60-some pages on his. But as you can see, it has the 5 items and then the wording that you had on it. Falling items been misplaced, lost by Amazon, and then you have those. And that's just a real simple file that you can just copy and paste right into Seller Central Help, which I'll show you he does. This is the Excel file that it downloads. It just downloads everything into one column altogether, Excel file, instead of breaking it up into 5 or 10 things. You can use the Excel file and copy and paste these 5, but I mean the Word file is just perfect. So to do that, you go to Help, Contact Us, Selling on Amazon, Fulfillment by Amazon, FBA Issue, Something Else, then you want to do your email, your contact reason, you want to do Lost Inventory, and then all you do is paste the files from that Word document right there, and submit your case. Then for me, I do one case a day. I think they recommend in this video you don't do any more than 2 a day. I wouldn't do any more than 2 a day either. You just do 1 a day, depending on how many you have. If you have over 60, then yeah, you could probably do 2 or 3 a day. But I only had, when I did mine, 10. So I'm just doing 1 a day for the 10-day free trial. That is basically it. I'll probably do another video or at least another post on the other locked ones whenever I unlock those and do mine. I can show you the pic of my first one that I sent in. And I put this in the group also, but I'll show it again here just in case you're not in our group. We have a Facebook group, FBA Sourcing Simplifiers. It's really good information in there. We're not all about selling in there. I mean, we do sell like Refund X-Ray. If you do purchase through our link, we do get a little bit of money back from you purchasing through our link. But we never promote stuff that we don't use ourselves or that we don't think is really good value. So keep that in mind. And yeah, we don't push any product just to get a couple dollars, because we're all active sellers. We all sell over 100,000 a year, 200,000. So FBA selling is our number one business, and then helping out sellers is second. So here's the, I submitted this July 30th. We got FBA inventory reimbursement, and then over the $99 that it cost for the thing on my first email. My second email did come back saying that we already found this inventory with dates, like I mentioned before. But these were shoes. I think the $18 one might have been a grocery, maybe coffee or something. And the $1.64 one, I think it was a bag of Oreos, if I'm not mistaken. But it wasn't bad on my first one. I'm hoping some of my other ones bring back some money too, and then the returns, which would be really good. So thanks for watching the video. I hope you sign up. And if you have any questions, you can ask in the group. You can PM me or any other admins. There's also Tedrick and Todd from OA X-Ray. They're always available for questions on refund or OA X-Ray. Tedrick, I would say, is more of the refund X-ray guy. And then Todd, he's the one I go to for OA X-ray. And I've never had a problem getting a hold of either one of them. They're really good guys. So thanks for watching, and see you in the group.